What to do with an unexpected two-factor code. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Get right to the question. Earlier today around midday, I suddenly received a TFA request from Microsoft on my mobile phone, the one where one has to select one of three numbers. It purported that someone from South Africa wanted to log into my Microsoft account. The fourth option on the request was refuse in red. I clicked that one. I've not noticed anything untoward afterwards, but now I'm not so sure I did the right thing. Shouldn't I simply have ignored the request, because it is time limited anyway, instead of clicking the red button? Refuse was exactly the right thing to do. Let's get that out of the way first. It doesn't help us all when we're getting so many different kinds of notifications via our phone. I want to go over what some of those are and what it means when you get one out of the blue. Sometimes it's benign. Sometimes it's not. So first, let's talk about what I'll call true two-factor authentication. When you use two-factor authentication on a machine you haven't signed into before, which would be our person in South Africa, here's what happens. You enter your username, you enter your password, the system sends you a code or a link or a notification or something via either email or your phone. You enter the code or click the link or tap the button, the number that you were shown, and you're in. There's something important about this sequence, though, that should set off some alarm bells. And that is simply this. In order for the system to actually send you a two-factor code or notification, you'll have had to have entered your password, and that password would have had to have been correct. So, if the system that's attempting to be compromised is a system where it is username, password, two-factor, if you suddenly get a two-factor that you didn't ask for, that means somebody entered your correct password. Two-factor saved you. That's the point. But it's now a great time to change the password on that account. Now, it gets confusing. Of course, things can't be simple. There are some services that actually change the order. For example, you'll enter your username. They'll send you a two-factor code. You enter the code you were sent, and then you enter your password. In other words, getting a random two-factor notification for this type of account actually means nothing. Nobody knows your password because they haven't gotten to the point where they had to enter it yet. Unfortunately, it's on you to know which way your service happens to behave. Most of them are username, password, two-factor. And if you need to make an assumption, make that assumption. But in the case where you know that a particular service is username, two-factor, password, then it's really not a big deal to get a two-factor code. It means nothing about your password. Now, there are scenarios that are not two-factor, but kind of feel similar. For example, you enter your username, the system sends you a code or a link or a notification, you act on that code, link, or notification, and you're in. This is a scenario for a passwordless account. If there's no password, they'll use this other technique to confirm that you are who you say you are. Those other techniques look a lot like two-factor notification. But since no password was going to be required, then the two-factor notification really doesn't tell you anything again. It tells you that somebody knows your username, they tried to sign in as you, but because you're going to reject that two-factor notification, which at this point is not a two-factor notification, right? It is essentially a single-factor notification. As long as you reject it, you didn't ask for it, you're safe. Okay, we're not done. There's the scenario where it might be two-factor. For example, you enter a username, you enter a password. The system communicates with the companion app on your phone. For example, any signed in Google app on your phone or the Microsoft Authenticator for a Microsoft account, similar kinds of scenarios. That app on your phone then asks you to usually indicate which number, a choice of three, is currently being displayed on the screen where you're trying to sign in. So you might enter your username, enter a password, and it will say then, here's a number, I'll just say 23. Now go check the notification app or the authentication app on your mobile device and tap that same number. The device will then show you three numbers. I don't know, 11, 23, 45. You tap on 23, that implies that you are you and you are the one trying to sign in. There's usually a reject button, which is probably what you experienced. Here's where I say might. Step two, enter your password, is optional in some cases. Some services don't use it. In other words, it's a fallback to single-factor authentication. You enter your username, it goes through this tap a code dance, and that's enough to confirm that you are who you say you are and should be allowed to sign in. So when this happens, we really don't know if a password has been involved at all. Once again, if you understand the normal sequence for the system that you use, you might not need to worry. But if the normal sequence involves a password, especially on a brand new machine that you haven't signed into before, then your password might have been compromised. I believe that it's going to get worse before it gets better. The scenarios that I've outlined are confusing. Absolutely, they are confusing. It's difficult sometimes to tell whether or not it's a two-factor or a single-factor code that you're receiving and whether or not it implies your password has or has not been compromised. Given that we're moving slowly to a passwordless future, like I said, I suspect that it's going to be a little bit of a bumpy road between here and there. We're going to have more of these kinds of confusions. But there is a wonderful, wonderful saving point here, is that if you're totally confused, if you just don't know, it is always safe to change your password. Whether you need to or not, some of these indications are that you should. Some of them don't tell you. The bottom line is, if you're not sure, go ahead and change your password. The worst that will happen to you is that, yeah, you might get logged out on some other sessions that happen to be logged into that same service using the old password. Great. Go over there and sign in again with your new password. Chances are you're using a password vault to manage it all anyway. And if you change your password, be sure to make it long and strong, and most importantly, unique. Unique to that one service. Never reuse passwords. Honestly, that's probably how we got here in the first place. Chances are there was a password leak, but it may not necessarily have been the service we're talking about. But if you were using the same password at both wherever it was leaked and this service, then yeah, this is exactly the kind of probe that hackers will be trying. So always feel free to change your password. Just make sure it's secure, strong, and unique. For updates, for comments, for links to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/170446. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.